Well, I'll run to my computer speed.
No, you're good.
Stream has started up. Welcome back, everybody. It's been a bit. Who wants to start us off with the recap? I feel like it's probably going to be Devin.
Okay, how far back am I supposed to go? Giant boars. Yep. Okay, Sylvanas, let's get the world map so I can look at the names. So if I remember how our sessions went, we had already arrived at Sirkhanis, where we delivered the map package and met some werebeast folks. They gave us information about the fact that the warforged or mechanized people or the people with the guns that we are facing off against are been moving through here, and they have been causing damage the entire time. Villagers have been keeping to themselves as best they can. We knew they were nearby, and we also found the location of the next guardian beast down the southern plains, but we kind of pushed it off to later. We then began our travels through the unnatural forests, where we came upon a pure white stag. Killick spoke with the deer. Unnatural creatures tamed the lake, where they're now smoking fire. Killick did astral projects and sees this all going on. They see the town. He sees the town burning. We rush over there to get on the point of exhaustion, but we arrive at the village that you're seeing now. At Lafar, we are able to stop the fighting. We do meet the Ranger General Baroth. He's been fighting the city for 3 days straight. This all kind of sort of happened all of a sudden when the Rangers were kind of searching the warehouses that we see above us. Kind of kicked off this surprise attack that wasn't fully prepared on either side. But we are able to go fight through. We break through the siege, and we are able to allow some rest for the villagers and the Rangers. We do need to eventually go to speak of the Archdruid, Leandra, to get reinforcements for Lafar, so we will eventually make our way towards the Great Tree in the capital. And we are given a personal sigil to go and allow passage to get to the capital and to provide him assistance, and we as a party leveled up.
Okay.
I feel like I could be missing stuff, but that's the most I got in my notes.
Callum tried to fireball all of us for the fuck of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's it. That's all I have bad.
Yep. So you've been tasked by General Baroth to send word to the capital that this is happening in Lafar, as he only really has enough rangers here to kind of contain the threat within Lafar, and that's about it. But what lies ahead in the actual town proper, he does not know the state of currently.
Cool, that was the rest of the town. Cool.
But yeah, that being said, you just finished fighting a group of warforged, including one that is relatively unfamiliar to you that did this strange ability just before it left that almost seemed to compress time upon you in some strange fashion. It hurt quite a bit.
Yes.
Display. So, at this time, the Rangers are busy picking over the remnants of the battlefield. Baroth has said that you can use one of these buildings here to rest in if you need to. But that as soon as you are ready to depart for the capital, he will send you with one of his scouts who can show you the way.
definitely need a rest.
So, what do you do?
I recommend we lay down and rest the old bone. I heard.
I agree. Resting would be a good idea to get one before we move on. Definitely provide us what we need, especially with as low of health as we got in this fight. I mean, Judy didn't. Is that the house to the north, east that we're resting as, or the one to the south of us?
Probably the ones further south are safer.
Okay.
The residents are currently gone, so it's kind of take your pick.
Perfect.
Zathmore, you can see a relatively untouched small family cottage.
Yeah. I guess I'll make it there for the night. Looks peaceful.
Peaceful enough.
Yeah.
You can actually see through that window there that the door is over here.
Side. Cool. I will figure out how to get myself over there.
Is everybody fine with simply bedding down for a bit and getting a rest in before venturing forth?
Yep.
Yep.
Because this would have happened not long after dawn, so there is still a full day ahead of you. You went all night, if memory serves correctly, to get there in time.
Yes.
Right. I will say, for the sake of expediency, that you make your way into that small family home and use that to rest. Tootie, quite a while ago, you were given an invitation. Do you wish to take up that invitation now?
Sure, I'll do that.
Okay.
Might as well. It's only polite.
Mm-hmm. And how would you like to go about that?
I don't want to go alone.
You don't want to go alone.
Especially after the journey we've been on so far. Kind of afraid of the dark.
Mm-hmm. I will remind you that you were asked specifically to come alone.
I know. Which is why I hope to wake up my trickster friend, whatever Burger's name is.
You want Halion to go with you?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll go, but I'm not going to like it.
Fair.
Okay.
Well, I feel like I'm gonna like it.
What capacity would you like Halion to go with you? Do you want him to tell you? Do you want him to like walk into the meeting with you?
I want him to tell me.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not gonna walk in the meeting with him. Fuck that. I'm like stupid.
Okay.
That's a suicide.
Right. Then I'll have a stealth check from both of you. I'll make yours, River, since you're away from your computer for the moment.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
Yeah, don't thank me yet.
Yeah, better luck than I do, normally. I can't even see the results of this. I kind of like it. It's like a blind roll.
You don't happen to have anything that allows you to reroll stealth checks, do you?
Oh, how low is it? How low is it?
It's 9.
A 9?
9.
What's my character sheet?
I don't see anything.
But you have lucky, aren't you?
You do have lucky. You can use a lucky.
Yeah, I'll use a lucky. Okay. Well, because the only reason why I ask is because technically anything that I have proficiency in, I should be getting... the minimum I can roll is a 10, technically. And so I was like, what's my bonus to stealth checks?
Oh, it's +4.
Okay, so that'd have been 13, or that'd have been a 14, technically, with that 9. So you can go ahead and use lucky, but if it's not better than a 9, then the 10 plus 4.
Actually, lucky only works if you roll a natural 1. So...
Oh. Yep, 10 plus 4, and I get... Well, I have a luck stone that gives me an additional +1 on ability checks, I believe. A lucky stone. That might have already been added in, though.
Stone of good luck, luck stone. While this polished gate is on your person, you gain +1 ability bonus to ability checks and saving throws.
Okay. So that would bring you up to a 15. That's pretty decent. Good to know.
Hooray!
All right, so you're going to have Haleon kind of tail you.
No utility, man.
Are the two of you letting any of the others know that you're going?
I think I'll let Zathmore know that I'm heading out, but I don't want everyone to follow.
All right. I will let others know if you don't get back by... What, do you want me to give you a day?
Less than that. Probably half a day.
Half a day? Sounds good. I'll give you half a day. If not, then we'll come after you.
That's actually an important question of when this happens. Does this happen before you rest or after?
Yeah.
After. Fucking. I already took the rest at the end of last session.
Okay.
So we were taking a rest.
That'll also apply that rest to Haleon.
Dead.
Nope. Okay. Then you are able to proceed forward with Haleon tailing from behind. Do you wish the rangers to see you go into the town?
No.
Okay.
I pick the wind. There's a wall. And we don't exactly know where forward is.
It's fine. You won't need it. Well, I guess you better hope you don't. Okay.
I rolled it again. But I rolled.
You did not roll, sorry. I was rolling for something else. I just had you selected. Okay. You managed to sneak past the barricade that they had set up without anyone else being the wiser and slip into the town. You can see that it's... Well... You're sure that once this was a lovely little town, but now it looks like a war zone. There are buildings burning throughout the town, as well as various bits of rubble and detritus lining the streets. A few bodies here and there. Even some bodies of the actual Warforged themselves lying about. But it's, for all that, it's relatively quiet. Let me have you make a couple of checks here to see how you manage to navigate the city to your destination.
Okay.
much like it is.
Thank you, Devin.
Let me first have you make a investigation check to see if you can suss out where you are supposed to be meeting your friend? Question mark? In the chaos of the streets, it's difficult to say. You know you're looking for a factory, but you have no idea where this factory would be located. You spend quite a bit of time walking about the town, trying to find your way, and eventually, after maybe 2 or 3 hours of walking, you manage to make your way there, almost by accident. Like, you turn down a street and it just happens to be there. Several hours later.
Well, if you make go left long enough, we'll end up right, I guess.
The factory kind of sits, kind of takes up an entire block almost by itself. It's a large building. It's currently dark. There are no lights on inside. And the streets around it are quiet and abandoned.
It's just like, is the factory like still look brand new or something? Or is it also destroyed and in shambles?
It has a bit of grunge to it, like it's dirty, but it doesn't look nearly as damaged as the rest of the town.
Shit. I guess I'll find the front door. Walk on in.
Okay. There is a set of doors, normal doors that lead inside, but there's also another set, a large gate that seems to be equipped to have carts of things brought in and out of it to offload supplies and take out product.
I think I'd go through the gate. So.
Okay. That leads you down into a sort of large loading zone where you can see several of those barrels that you had seen within Lyran, the port town that you originally entered Sylvanas from.
Is there like, can you give me a quantity of them? Like, how many I might see?
There are
more or less than what we saw.
Much more.
Much more.
Industrial scale.
Jesus. Okay, this is a little worrying, but. I'll press on forward. Pass them.
Okay.
Making a mental note.
Make me one more stealth check, please. And are you having Haleon follow you into the building or wait outside?
I think as I was going in, I would kind of signal him maybe not to go in the way that I did.
Okay.
Maybe find a different way in.
I'm looking for a window.
Okay. There do appear to be windows. However, they're mostly on more of like a second or third floor of the building.
That's unfortunate because I'm a tiny man.
Yep.
I have 50 feet of rope.
The magical 50 feet of rope.
Am I able to... Is there anything that I can attempt to create like a lasso and toss that rope up? Try to haul myself up to somewhere?
There's probably like a catwalk that runs alongside one part of the building, sure.
Yeah, that's what I would like to do, is try to get a vantage point up on that catwalk using like 50 feet of rope or whatever way I need to get up.
Okay.
If I can.
Let's see. We'll have you make an athletics check to see if you can climb up.
Let's go. You have a rope for me still, I'm sorry.
Yeah, do you need me to roll it for you?
Please, I'm still not there yet.
17. Not too bad.
Let's go.
You climb up the rope and find yourself kind of perched in... next to a window that gives you a pretty decent view of the floor below. Inside, you can see that there are several catwalks that kind of run along the level that you're on as well, high above the factory floor. But you can see down to the floor from this position. You can see, as Tootie is entering the main factory floor from the loading bay, a number of shapes moving inside.
Oh, great. I don't know why he didn't bring the telepathic one.
I'm not sure why either. But, be it as it may, you can see Tootie beginning to walk into the main factory floor, and that the shapes moving around become a bit clearer as they walk out of the various shadows of the factory floor to keep an eye on Tootie as he enters. And they are all very much familiar shapes of Warforged that you have fought, and some that you haven't seen before. Some new configurations that you haven't had the opportunity to tangle with yet.
New upgraded models.
Upgrades people, upgrades.
And?
Upgrade people, we need upgrades.
And sitting on a railing at about the second floor, also somewhat overlooking the factory floor, is the hunter himself. Tootie, you can see this all as you walk into the factory floor. The Warforged around you, emerging behind various crates and boxes. And the hunter himself sitting up on a railing, looking down at you. He's currently unarmed, at least. His weapon is slung over his shoulder.
I guess I'll call out to him. It's good to see you again.
Well, 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 color me surprised. I didn't expect you to actually accept the invitation. He casually hops down from the railing down to the factory floor level.
Well, it's only
polite. So, other than being polite, what brings you here? What do you expect to come from this meeting?
Honestly, I don't know anymore after coming halfway across the country here. It's changed my perspective.
Oh.
What you're doing. So I want to see what you have to say.
What I have to say is that what you're doing, while noble, is ultimately pointless. You defeat us here, you defeat me even, and there are three others just like me. Just as powerful. And they're off in the world doing their own thing as well.
And wouldn't you say what you're doing is pointless? If someone else is doing the work for you.
We are working as a collective to bring things to an end as painlessly as possible. Frankly, you mortals have been living in bliss for gods know how long at this point. And I envy you that. But believe me when I say all this chaos is to help you in the end.
I don't really see how dying is doing much helping, but...
Later tonight. It's going to take us an hour to cool off.
What is a few lives in comparison of that of all the life on this world?
Well, then what do you have to offer for me? You told me to meet you here. I expect it was more than just to tell me this.
I offer you a choice. So far, your group has been meddling into things that they really shouldn't be meddling in, and it will cause them some amount of danger. I offer protection for yourself and a place of comfort when our plans come to fruition.
What about my group?
I mean, unless you can simply convince all of them to stand down, I don't believe that they have quite the same drive as you do.
And I think that's kind of where you're mistaken.
Oh?
You see, I do have the same drive as them, and I don't think that your plans should go through. Because wouldn't they in fact be pointless if I was still around? You wouldn't have exterminated everyone. You can't have exterminated everyone.
Not even I am prideful to say that I've exterminated everyone, but you may change your mind when you see what comes next. He reaches into a pouch, slowly, to indicate that he's not doing anything hostile. And he pulls out a metal disc about the size of his hand. It's a silvery disc that seems to be etched with lines of gold. And in the center, there is some sort of emerald-looking stone.
Is that supposed to be a bride?
It's your salvation if you choose to use it. And he hands it out to you.
I'll look at it for a few seconds. And then I'll just throw it on the ground.
It clangs metallically on the stone floor and rolls away. The hunter's face is solid and cannot tell if it has angered him or anything. He shows no emotions. He simply says, "You, of course, may do with it what you will. It is a gift. But when the time comes to use it, and it will be very clear when you must use it, if you do not have it with you, you will wish you did."
I'm going to start walking away, and I'm just going to say that when the time comes and we do meet again, I'm going to make sure that you're taken down quickly. It's only kind.
When the time comes, my dear mortal friend, you won't even hear the shot that takes you down. And he turns and walks away from you as well, deeper into the factory. Hey, Leon, you being up top, of course, you didn't hear much of the conversation. What you saw was the hunter jump down, share some words with Tootie, go to hand him something, and Tootie taking it and just throwing it on the ground. Then both of them walking away.
I'm just going to stand by still. I still know what's going on. Nobody's attacked yet. I'm not sure, but I know he's not in danger, so I'm still just watching.
In fact, as 2D begins to leave, it seems all the Warforged just kind of begin to melt back into the shadows of the factory.
Okay. Do I notice the main Warforged going anywhere? Or is he staying?
He goes further in. There appears to be a set of doors on the opposite side of the factory floor. You can't quite tell from your position where they open up into, but he certainly goes through those doors.
I think I'm just going to... I did my job. I was just here about to put shit hit the fan for 2D. I'm just going to eyeball on 2D and keep an eye out for anything else suspicious while he escapes. Or until I know he leaves safely.
Sure enough, 2D is able to leave without attracting any attacks or any pursuers, as far as you can tell. And within short order, you're able to meet back up with them, and you have a few moments before you return past the barricade and meet back up with the rest of the party. Should you care to discuss?
Do you mind telling me what happened in there?
I just turn to him and they start fucking huffing and gasping. Oh boy, that fucking... Oh, my heart! That was scary, dude.
Alright. Instead of telling me what the fuck happened.
Well, you know. Nothing new. He's just still a dick. And we gotta kill him. So
that. It's not an inaccurate summary of the conversation, I suppose.
Yeah. Inspiring, but not inaccurate. Okay. Are we going to let the rest of the team know what happened here tonight?
Yeah, I just need to catch my breath for a second.
Okay. You want to go grab a pint?
We'll find just a random fucking...
A random, abandoned, somewhat destroyed tavern?
Yep, exactly. I'm gonna use knock and just blow a door in on a fucking empty pub.
This is
the best beat.
There is no one to stop you at the moment.
I'm gonna pour us both a mug and I'm gonna leave silver on the table.
Fair enough.
Jeez.
I'm gonna try to chill Tootie down.
Very good booze.
I need to pay for the door I just shattered.
Oh, there we go.
Mm-hmm.
So the booze and the door. And I'm probably still a little something left over.
But yeah, I think we'd head back to the group.
Okay.
And then we're gonna head there.
You make your way back. And before long, you are now on the other side of the barricade and back into the small family home that your group has
occupied.
Yeah, that's the word I was looking for the day while you guys rest. Zathamore, of course, is you being the only other one to be aware of the situation and only needing 4 hours to rest.
Yep.
Probably awake and aware enough for their return.
Well, you're back. And with enough time to spare. I am shockingly impressed.
Yeah, he was kind of boring and didn't really offer anything new. So,
I mean, you're alive. That's new.
Yeah, nothing new.
I still don't know entirely what happened. I just know that Tootie told me he was being a dick.
Is there anything actually important that I should know about? Or are you good just keep it to yourself?
Already know, so.
I'm going to tell him that I'm assuming you gave Haley on the full rundown. So I'm going to let him also tell him that he said that even if we defeat him, there's 3 more to take his place.
Well, that seems is like usually we've got a four
horseman kind of issue going here.
Well, that's how most gangs always operate. Well, take down one and they all scurry to go fill in the void.
More of that toxic waste stuff than I've ever seen. Than I've ever seen booze.
That may be more important than what you initially led on to.
No, that's fine.
You said something about this was only the beginning. We thought what we saw so far was bad. It was going to get worse.
There's some pretty scary figures there.
But, you know.
Well, I guess as long as we have time, we can do the best we can to get everyone else prepared. Yeah. If they're foolish enough to at least even show us the taste of their power, that gives us enough knowledge of a forefront to begin preparations.
True.
So what it sounds like, what you guys heard, that might not do much for us. I'll figure out a way to pass on this information then, I guess. Gotta keep the boss man in the loop.
Don't forget to tell work, Daddy.
Yeah. Well, if there's anything else you guys need, let me know. I will step aside and go deliver that information, I guess. I say as I kind of fiddle with as I know now, a bullet that I have in my pocket that the hunter gave me.
Bullet with the name!
Yeah.
I can.
I guess I'll... Party's inside there. I guess I'll just be... I'll kind of move away from the group and kind of use the sending stone to go...
Report in.
Report in and say that we need to talk. Or I have information I need to give.
Okay.
Because I don't feel like I can tell everything within 10 words.
Okay. The response back is make report at the hub when most practicable.
Understood. Or supply back and then return back to the group.
A few hours later, the long rest for everyone is completed. And it's... it's getting close to about mid-afternoon now in the day, so you could do some traveling if you desired, or you could stay through the night and make your way out in the morning.
I want to go out. Unless you guys want to do something else.
Oh yeah, I'm down for traveling at night.
I guess I'll see what the says what our the guide says is the best idea.
We do have our hunter. He's good at night.
Yeah, the whenever you're ready, you can let Baryath know and he'll give you a scout.
I don't think we need anything, right? We all got our long rest.
Got a long rest. There's nothing to loot here. And we really shouldn't loot a burning village.
Oh, yeah, totally not. Oh, why would anyone do that?
Mm-hmm.
Bad guy in the story. Couldn't be me. I have nowhere else to go. Where's the map? Where were we headed to before this happened again?
We need to get to the capital.
Oh yeah, we made a pit stop because we heard they were going to get attacked.
Probably need a hurry.
Well, the two options are the capital, Sylvain, or go down to the plains and go fight another giant beast. But at the time scale we're in, the capital makes the most sense.
Put it off long enough.
That is your most pressing...
That's kind of the job why we're here and made a death pact to go and do.
No, we do all the side quests.
Yeah, dude, do all the side quests. So when we get to the final boss, we just one-shot him.
Oh, if only it were that easy.
It's never that easy. Well, that's not true. I did one-shot a boss once.
Yeah, that is true. Technically speaking.
It shouldn't be that easy.
I say we put it off long enough.
Okay. So you're gonna head out now, mid-afternoon?
I mean, we have our hunter. Our hunter's good at his surroundings, right, Lonnie? Your character's good at that at night?
We also have a guide.
You could take our guide if he wants to go.
Yeah, the guide's got night vision.
Oh, they're an elf, so. Yeah, the scout that Baryath kind of gives you on loan is an elven woman. She seems taciturn. She's been doing this a while.
She's seen some stuff. Said her name was Taciturn?
No, she is. Her demeanor is taciturn.
Introduce myself. What is your name, madam?
I'm Ranger Captain Tria.
Well, if you are to be our guide, you think it's wise to leave right now on our way to Silwyn, or should we wait for the morning? Experience, what's around these parts?
I think in this case, time is of the utmost essence. It is not necessarily safe to move through the forest at night. But I believe our task is urgent.
Well, I feel the same way. We need to make haste to the capital with all the information and everything that we know.
We should be fine as long as we stick to the roads, more or less.
Say we head on out, unless my party needs to do something else.
Nope, I'm good to go. I've done my job.
Who else needs to do stuff? Any of you?
Nope. Hit the road.
Right. As you go back to where you had effectively stabled your stalkers for a bit, you see Tria kind of walk a short ways away from the wall and whistle really loudly. And out of the trees surrounding the clearing that makes up the town, you see a large, almost black stag run out of the woods. It is saddled. And as you mount up on your stalker, she mounts up on the stag.
I'll ask for her to lead the way then.
She'll urge her mount into a gallop and lead you on along the path towards the capital. Yep, always.
Nice.
Well, then roll away, Keith.
Last time I did it, no. Who rolled for the Kraken thing? No, it wasn't a Kraken, it was a giant turtle. That was Lonnie. I'll do it, though. Let me know when.
Go ahead.
Go for it.
I forget, it's roll 1, D100, right?
Slash R.
Slash roll.
Yeah. Space 1D100.
Slash roll space D100. 4T. That's an average number. I ain't gonna do nothing. I regret my choice of words.
You spontaneously combust.
Yo, I like to think.
Interesting. We must take scientific note about this.
Even going at speed, it is going to take you about 2 days to make the capital. On the first day, you go pretty well on into the night until such a point where your guide calls for you to at least take a bit of a rest. Since she knows that you all don't quite have the same benefits as she does, is being able to only take a quick 4-hour nap and be fine for the next day. She finds a space shortly, a short walk away from the road to make a camp. Although she requests that no one starts any fires. As to not give away your positions. And Callum, as you sleep during this rest, you dream. You dream of riding through the woods, as you have been for the last little while, but it's different. Everything is too vibrant. Everything is too colorful. Everything's too bright. It's like the forest itself has a life of its own. You could swear, as you're riding through the forest, that some of the trees seem to be moving, not just from the motion of you moving past it, but its own movement. And in those few parts where you can look up at the sky and actually see sky and not trees above you, the sky is wrong. It's much too colorful. The constellations don't line up. It's almost like you're on a whole different world.
Like that line.
But when you wake up, everything is normal.
So, basically high. That's what I'm getting off of that. I will ask, well, whenever we wake up, all of us, in the morning, I'll ask Tree if she knows of any travelers having weird visions around these parts, or like anybody messing with anyone's dreams in the area whenever we fully wake up in the morning.
Well, it's possible. The forest is... Well, this entire area is quite closely linked with the Feywild. Sometimes people think that some aspects of the Feywild bleed over into our world. Perhaps this is what you saw.
Could it be an indication of danger or anything ahead, by chance?
Not necessarily. But one must always be cautious here. Especially because of the Feywild's involvement.
I'll take note of that. And let everyone know just to be cautious as we proceed forward, as we get closer to the capital. I feel like danger is around us.
The capital sits in a bit of a valley. It won't be too much longer before we should be able to see its spires above the trees. And with that, you begin your journey for the second day. Who would like to make a random encounter roll for the second day?
Close.
How dare you, Lonnie? Slash roll. And this guy codes for a living? I'm kidding.
Oh, thanks. Gosh, I found a unicorn.
My gosh, I hope not.
And the goats again.
Are unicorns bad?
Yes.
The fucking goats.
Always the goats.
You are begin riding through when your scout slows her mount up ahead to a walk and begins to look very closely at the trees around you. Everybody make a perception check.
That's not good.
Wait, it's my time to shine.
God damn it.
Gosh darn it.
You're supposed to be the best one.
I have a plus 9.
You're supposed to be the best one.
Whatever.
All of you...
You have a plus 9.
I literally have a plus 9.
All of you can clearly see because your scout, Tria, is pointing it out that many of the trees surrounding the path in this part of the forest seem desiccated. In fact, a lot of them have tumbled over and look to be hollow inside. Ragmir, Callum, and Halion, you guys can smell this strange scent around the area that reminds you very strongly of the acidic vapors of the toxic sludge. Perhaps this was a dumping ground.
Gross.
I'm surprised, and be surprised that it's this close to the capital that we're finding all of this. A little bit suspicious. But if I recall correctly, nobody's heard from the capital in like weeks, right?
Correct.
Okay. So when we get there, we might not even find a government or anything. We might just find a destroyed city, possibly.
After taking a look around, Tria turns to all of you and tells you, I think we better keep moving. This is a problem, but one for another day. Just past this ridge, we should be able to see the city before us. She begins to make her way back down along the path.
I'll follow along next, as it makes no sense to stay around the toxic sludge land anyway.
The next bit of the path seems to go into much more varied elevations. It's very hilly here, so you're going up and down, up and down. And at the tallest ridge you guys cross, Tria stops very suddenly. It's not there.
Excuse me?
It's not there.
The tree.
Wait, what?
I don't see the spires of Silwyn.
Wait. The entire city is gone?
She doesn't answer, but kicks her mount into a gallop down the road towards where the city should be.
We're chasing.
Several minutes of hard riding later, you come across a bit of a breakage in the forest. Up on a hill. And instead of a large Elven City, the capital jewel of all of Elven civilization, there is nothing. Nothing except what looks to be a large city-sized crater.
Well, he did say That was only the beginning. But I wasn't expecting this level.
I think any of us were.
Is there anywhere that they would have fled to in case they may have known of the dangers coming?
Tria seems almost lost. She's having trouble
processing,
yes.
I think she's in shock. I don't think we're going to get much out of her in this state. I suppose we should probably go and investigate.
The shrine, she says suddenly. We have to check the shrine.
All right, lead the way.
And she wheels her mount off of the road and begins making a roundabout way around what would be the left-hand side of the city walls, should they be there still. Yeah, they're up here. As you make your way off the beaten path, you find yourselves traveling along a less worn path. Something that doesn't seem to be used all that much. It is a bit overgrown with weeds and foliage. And peeking through the trees, you see what looks to maybe be a large telescope.
Oh, yeah.
There it is.
You also see, shining a bit through the trees, a green glow.
What is that?
Are we allowed to move forward in this land, Tria?
You can.
Or is there something special?
Oh, you're asking.
We should honor. Yeah.
She says, this is a place of last resort. Our people call it the Shrine of Exedition. We need to check and see if it's been used. She'll begin.
I'll make my way forward with her then. Do my best to stay up upon the path.
the path begins to slope downwards into a depression of sorts, where you see stone structures rising out. It appears that this was once a much more elegant temple. However, much of it has fallen into disarray. It is old. There is a large central stone platform around which is arrayed four would almost look to be altars. Large enough for a medium-sized humanoid to be laid upon. And above all of this is a floating orb of greenish energy that just sits magically suspended above it all, bobbing slightly up and down. And laying underneath the glowing orb is a corpse. Tria rushes over to inspect.
That looks pretty used to me.
I think I have some medicine skills. Yeah, I do. Cool.
What I miss.
I will join her at the corpse.
We found a body.
Okay, but the capital's gone.
It's a crater.
Oh, okay.
There is the body of a woman. She is dressed in robes that appear to be made of some sort of animal pelt and feathers. She's wearing a crown that is made up of the antlers of deer or similar creature. And she is laying in a dried pool of blood.
Can I investigate the body, kind of to look for any how she died?
Sure.
Would we rather just ask her?
Yeah, I'm sure Trey would know. Yeah, that would work.
I am a cleric. We can talk to the dead.
Oh, shit, that's right. I kind of forget about that spell.
It is.
Go for it.
It is a useful spell.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't see why not.
After watching the D&D movie, this is kind of funny.
You quickly set up what you need to cast the spell. And you watch as there is this odd sensation surrounding all of you in the midst of this spell. And you see as these small motes of greenish light begin to rise from the dirt around you that form into one mass and pass into the body. The body eyes open and sit up and look to you, Ragnar.
Can you tell us what happened here?
We were betrayed. Forced to cast the rite of exedition too early.
Who betrayed you?
I am not sure. One of the elders. There was rumors, but I know not who. Did the deed. You have 3 more questions remaining.
Anyone else have any input?
What caused the crater where the city used to be? Was it the right you're speaking of?
The right. It transports the city to the Feywild. For safekeeping.
Next.
2 questions remaining.
Oh, that is very generous. That was definitely 2 questions that Lonnie just asked.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say anything.
It's like 2 and 1, you know?
It still counts as 2.
Technically, yeah.
Magic is all about technicalities.
Yeah. I'll be kind and say you still have 2 questions remaining.
Yeah. All right, turning away from the end.
Yeah,
for a second.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Should we look over at the undead? We're not talking to you for a second. should we try to figure out, like, what are we most worried about? Like, should we try to figure out who did this, or like
the city?
Like, what's the most important thing right now that we need to
She told us that Elder betrayed them, the right took the city to the Fae. Is there, I wonder if we ask if there's a way we could to bring it back or get into the Fae and see what's going on, and maybe she knows a passageway.
Well, it seems like that would be going through the doing the right a second time. We teleport us in. Though it doesn't look pain like the best idea.
True.
But I'm down for you asking whatever. I mean, we're sent here to go talk to a druid, and unless that's the ceremonial clothes, that looks very druidic to me.
Tria will come over and say, yes, this is the body of the archdruid.
Yeah, go ahead and ask that question, Sathamore. Oh, might mess it up.
I don't think she can help us with what we need to ask her for.
Doesn't know. She was surprised.
Maybe we can, as a kind gesture, see if she, I don't know, wants us to do anything for her. Maybe she's got loved ones somewhere we can tell. I don't know. Or we could just walk away.
We're not going to leave the body animated for 2 more questions.
I'm never going to ask, what kind of absolute hell are you trying to inflict on them?
It only lasts for 10 minutes.
Yeah.
That's still 10 minutes of just sitting there being like, are you going to ask me something?
That's true.
I guess we could ask how the Queen Adventure, since she feels betrayed.
The dead, unblinking eyes turn to you, Zathamore.
Yeah.
And she says, Reverse the right. Punish those responsible.
Nice. Maybe we could leave the last question for our guide. I mean, these are her people. Maybe there's just something she wants to ask.
Yeah, it's true. That's a good point, friend. When did you get so smart?
I'm watching a movie.
What should? What would Tria ask her?
I just want to watch Chris talk to himself.
Tria will kneel down next to the body and say, Archdruidess, you did not proclaim a successor. Who shall I inform that they are the new Archdruid? The eyes turn to her, to Tria. And the Archdruidess says, seek out my daughter in Ryleth. She was always intended to be my successor. And with the final question, you see that mote of greenish light pull out of the body, the eyes close, and she falls back to the ground, lifeless. The mote floats for a moment or two above the body, and then begins to break off piece by piece until it is no more.
Where should we start?
Perhaps we ought to look around and see if anything here at the shrine will tell us how to reverse this. Then after that, we should report back to Bariath. He is effectively the next person in charge of what's left of us.
Is there anything interesting around this telescope?
This telescope has some stairs that lead up, and you see that there's almost like a seat where one can sit and look through the telescope. It's tall enough to stick above much of the trees in the area.
I'm gonna go see what it was looking at.
You look and you see clear skies, a set of mountains in the distance. Make a general intelligence check.
Just a general, like a raw?
Yep.
I'm going to do this raw.
Mm-hmm.
That one.
Pretty close.
It's just pointing out to nowhere.
Man, this thing's useless.
You jump off of the telescope. Fly down into the pit. Like the vampire you are. Tria steps away to have a moment to herself.
Is this green, does this thing magic, this green ball here?
Well, I think considering
I'll take the Archdruidish's body and go bury it someplace. How about over here in the field of flowers?
Very well. Is there anything else you would like to investigate about her body before you do so?
Sure. Kind of just, yeah, I'll investigate the body. Why not?
Medicine check.
Yes.
Okay. Well, it's difficult to say when she could have died. You know that they hadn't heard any word from the capital in some time, several weeks. But the body doesn't appear to have been dead that long. Perhaps preserved in some way. It seems like there is signs of blunt force trauma to the back of her head. But you do not believe that that is what has killed her. However, her arms and her legs all have an enormous amounts of long, thin cuts. Almost as if someone had taken a knife and had begun to draw arcane symbols into her very flesh. It was probably quite agonizing and a long, slow, and painful death.
Make a note of it all and kind of write down and try to kind of copy the symbols, or at least just get a general census on some notes, on some parchment. Just to know I could just see if I can find someone who can match that one day. Because I feel like people who know these symbols are not as common in these lands as it would be.
Also, she doesn't have much on her person other than her clothing and her cape that is made of the aforementioned feathers and various animal pelts. She does have a small pouch on her which seems to contain maybe dried reagents of spells. Things that she would use in her druidcraft. And she does have a staff.
Is the headdress connected to the cape by any means? Or is it kind of separate?
It is a separate.
Okay.
Item.
I will, before I bury the body, I'll carefully remove the cape, take the staff and the reagents pouch, and I'll kind of put them together, kind of put the pouch inside, right next to the staff, kind of wrap them up with the cloak, cape, and I'll give these off over to her daughter when we meet her, as a kind of providing her some semblance of moving on, I guess.
Closure.
Closure, yeah.
Understood.
I guess I will then call to Treya. Is there any last words you want to say over the body before I bury it?
She'll come over and Honestly, I did not know her. But she was well respected and well loved by many.
And such a loss is much too great for anything to handle. But the least we can do is at least return her back to the Earth. To the Earth Mother, to at least provide the chance for the cycle to continue again.
Agreed. There will be time to mourn when
there's is time all available.
Over. Yep.
Chill. I'll bury the body, say a prayer in Elvish, also pray up to my deity to allow the spirit to move on, and then return back to the group.
Okay. Meanwhile, as Athamor is doing all that, what are the rest of you doing? Down in the ruins.
I want to check out this hole.
Hole?
Giant hole. What are you talking about, this?
It's like my character. Why?
What's wrong?
River can't move himself.
And I don't know why.
I also don't.
I had the proper thing selected to move my token, but it's locked out. I just really wanted to check this out.
Got permission to it, so I don't know what the deal is. Okay. Can you make rolls?
Can I make a roll? Let's see. I can make rolls. I don't know.
Weird.
Yeah, I can make a roll.
Okay. We'll make me a perception check then.
Okay. Perception.
Okay.
Another 13.
What you're looking at there is a small basin, which you'd expect would normally have water in it, but it is currently dry. Although it's difficult to tell its function.
Okay. Well, now I can move. What the hell?
I don't know.
I didn't do anything. I just clicked on him again.
I didn't change anything either, so... Yep. Aelion's looking at the basin.
I kind of want to go in it. Or reach a hand in it. Not climb in it, just reach a hand in it. Dip down, inspect the water.
It is dry.
Like a vial. Oh, it's dry?
It is
then
dry.
I am going to climb in it.
Yep. Hop down into it, and it's deep enough where probably a normal elf-sized person could comfortably sit in it about waist deep.
So I'm just completely gone once I get in there?
It would be, yeah, you would be swimming in there if it was full of water. Well, Hylion's playing in his hole. What are the rest of you doing?
I wanted to look around and see if there's anything left over for us to use. Would that be like perception or like investigation?
If you're looking at something specific, it's going to be an investigation. But if you're just generally looking around to see what catches your eye, then perception.
Just generally looking around. Let's see if there's anything we could use while our guide's taking her moment. Hey, yo.
As you're scanning the area, the taller slab that sits on the end of the altar-like thing sprouting from the main platform, you notice it's engraved.
Am I able to read this at all? I'm guessing it's just written in common, or no?
It is not. It's written in a language that you do not understand.
Tria comes back, I'll see if she could decipher it or see if she's able to read it, since I'm not able to. I'm assuming no one in the party. I don't know what language it is either, right, you said?
Nope, no idea.
No one in the party would
be either.
Tria, we'll come over based on your request. It is an archaic version of Elvish, of Sylvan.
Can you read any bits or pieces out of it by chance?
It is a title, I think. The words on this one say Irain Odkendi, which is it refers to, the literal translation would be King of the Speakers. All right, Tria, how much do you know about your own history here?
Nothing at all.
A decent amount, as it turns out. She'll say, Kendi is an old term that has, in recent times, come to refer to people that play music and sing songs, write tales, and scribes and scholars and bards.
Hmm? My ears peek up. My head pokes out of the basin.
Yep. It's an old word that references people of that nature. People who derive great power from song and spoken and written word.
I'll take note that on this adventure we've been, music has kind of played an important role in everything we've been doing so far. How would I think about it? I'll say thank you and I appreciate her explaining. I know this will be a tough time for her.
She walks over to the southernmost one. She says, this one has an engraving as well. Irain Amandil. Amandil is a spiritual leader. A priest, or perhaps a druid in our case.
Looking around, crawl out. Is there any more inscriptions on any of these other ones? Maybe like anything that recognizes music or something?
There are certainly engravings, even on the inside, And as Tria goes around, she tells you that there's engravings on the other two as well, on the back sides of them. But nothing that jumps out at you as being like any sort of musical notation. Not this time.
Darn.
This one here is labeled as Irene od Feroth, which she tells you Feroth is a hunter. And then the final one is Irene Elier, or a king of visionaries, soothsayers, magicians.
Like a grand mage almost.
Sorcerer, even. Someone of a magical persuasion.
Like a grand mage or a night scholar kind of guy?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry,
I'm writing everything down. Hope someone is.
I am. Mm-hmm.
This may be on the test.
Write that down.
I'm trying to build a correlation between that and the music temple, but
mm-hmm.
and the full place that we cannot enter.
Tell me I can't go somewhere.
Are you trying to orient yourself, Zathamore?
I'm trying to see which way this telescope is pointing. I gotta look inside it, then look back at the orb.
It would be pointing north.
Cool.
So this direction, roughly speaking, is north.
That's north, cool.
So if you go to the map real quick.
Yeah.
You guys are somewhere
roughly down there.
Yeah, roughly in that region. Go ahead.
I guess I'll do the same check that Killick did.
Yep, just a straight intelligence check.
Well, I don't have negatives, so that's cool. Yeah, no. I could... Don't want to roll tonight. Cool.
It happens.
Yeah. We
have our nights. It just so says it. Doesn't even do anything.
Mountains north. Cool.
It also seems to be like stuck in this position. Like it cannot be moved.
Oh, well, I was about to ask that question. If it seemed movable, so that's perfect. Locked in place to the north. Mm-hmm.
Take a check at it. Me being a scholar and my intelligence is high, I'll see if I can get or notice anything through it.
Go for it.
Roll a one.
Don't say that.
14. Not bad. You
be nuts.
Thinking about where you are and this shrine's importance. You expect that the telescope is aligned so that you would see the spires of the city in the distance.
So now there's nothing there.
But, correct, as there is nothing there currently, you do not see them. You imagine it's a way, since you're, you know, a decent ways away from the city, to tell if the right has activated properly or not.
Gotcha.
And you would assume has been deactivated properly.
Well, I feel like we've explored this area. Is there anything else you guys want to take a look at?
Well, there are the inscriptions on the inside of the of those structures, if you wanted to read them.
Yes, please.
The connection, the music.
Let's see.
The numbers, Mason.
Tria will read it. And it's just like the old inscriptions from the tomb of Lindalie. They don't translate perfectly, even to modern Elvish. So she is telling you what she believes it to be, what she believes it to be saying. And basically she says something along the lines of, by the blood of one, to usher us all into safety. Okay. And by the reunion of the four kings of the forest, Eren Otar, to bring them back again.
She translated that way better than I did.
She knows what she's talking about, dude. Not us.
She studied a little bit.
Yeah. I just have Elvish Elvish.
That's all you have is Elvish Elvish.
He's classically Elvish trained, not realistic Elvish trained. Like the difference between learning Spanish in high school and actually getting out there and learning Spanish.
I mean,
I speak Elvish, but I speak Elvish from the highland, from the lands of humans, not the land of elves.
I mean, Zathmore, you reading as well get pretty much a similar thing. It's just it uses words that aren't really used anymore. It's like old English for us. There are words that still mean the same thing today. It's just people don't use them, and so when you run across them for the first time, you're like, "The fuck does this mean?"
Hey, Halion, can you put your weird magical lyre over on the
statue of the poet? Yeah.
Yeah. Which would be the one that Killix has at.
Whee! You're gonna put the lament down onto the altar?
But I'm not gonna let go of it.
Fair. You set it down onto the cold gray slab of the altar. Wait. But nothing happens.
Cool.
What if I just begin to pluck a tune while at the altar? Nothing specific.
You begin to pluck a few mournful strings. I've totally forgot I haven't been playing music this whole time. Holy shit. What is wrong with me?
We're out of it.
I'm in my mind's theater, it doesn't matter.
Plucking away, and while the music is beautiful and remorseful, does not seem to do anything. Yep.
That's okay. I just wanted to see if that was going to do something first before we had to go back and figure out how to break into a tomb.
Is there any inscriptions like around the base of this orb?
Not that you can see.
Okay. Does anybody have create water?
Let me see here my great spell book of nothing.
looks over at the monk. Shut it.
I can shoot lightning out of my hands. I mean, it's magical, but it ain't doing shit. But yeah. Where was that located at? I've been with a hag, so I think that was after that.
Is this just a broken pillar?
Seems like it once held up a larger structure that is lost to time.
I'm just sniffing around for any other clues. Mm-hmm. Finding nothing. I'm going to lay under a tree.
Make a perception check.
Okay. Big money, big money, big money. Wow.
The flowers up here are quite beautiful.
Wow. That was... It was rough.
Oh, cool. I thought you were looking at my dead body of flowers.
Tria does not seem to come across anything herself either.
Okay. So that means we have to go back to Lafar, to go back to Aretha.
Any other investigating and exploring you guys would like to do?
Nope, I'm just going to plop in the grass and contemplate, ponder my orb.
Is this thing magical? What happens if I touch it?
The orb is floating several feet up above the ground. 15, 20 feet. And glowing green. It's a pretty safe bet. It's magical. In fact, make a perception check while you're looking at it.
Come on, perception. Wow.
You're not sure, but there's something inside of the orb. A shape. Can't quite make out what it is. Almost like a smudge within.
Amberfoot, come here. Let me throw you.
All right.
I'm gonna throw him into the orb.
You're gonna try and throw him up into the orb.
Okay. Yeah, I got a rope around me just in case I go in it.
Alright, we'll tie rope.
Magic 50 feet of rope come in handy.
Okay. Make an athletics check to see if he can toss him that high. You take your hands and hold them down like you're going to give someone a buddy lift. And as Haleon steps into it, you just throw with all of your might. Haleon, you rush up and through the air, and with an audible ding, smack into the side of the orb.
I left for 2 minutes. What happened?
trying to take a closer look at the orb, so I got thrown at it.
You take 2 points of bludgeoning damage.
Ow.
As you not only hit the orb, but then slide off of the orb, as it is a smooth surface, and onto the ground below.
What was in there?
Did I take a good, get a good look?
Make a perception check. We'll see that that's happening while you're flying towards it.
I'm not with these guys, Tria. I don't know who they are.
Yeah.
18. There is a comical moment where you're face to face with with this glass-like orb, and you're looking inside of it as close as you can get without somehow breaching the orb itself. And it looks like that smudge that's in the middle looks to be a city.
A city?
Yeah. Like a small miniaturized version of the city of Silwyn.
Fellas, I know what happened to the city. It's inside the orb. They got Santa Claus.
I think you hit your head a little too hard.
They're in there!
He says, lying on his back, pointing up at the orb about 20 feet above him now at this point.
I'm telling you, it's most definitely up there. I know I say a lot of crazy shit. But I mean, if this spell was meant to transport the city somewhere, well, what if they fucked up the spell and it just got transported somewhere wrong? Now we can see it within this orb. Maybe it's not inside the orb so much as where the city is at. This orb allows us to see where it's at. But either way, this is our chance, our hint. I'm just gonna look at them all wide-eyed and crazy looking. Believe me!
I'll ask the guide, what's with the city in the center of the orb?
I don't know, to tell you the truth. I expect the city is not inside the orb, but that we are looking at a representation of the city.
Calum, can't you like do like a location spell or something? Aren't you like a wizard or something?
He's a combat wizard. He doesn't do anything useful except blow shit up.
Oh.
Well, let's see what he's got in his spell book. Does not have anything useful for this situation.
Does he have much utility at all? Because I don't remember him having much utility at all.
He is mostly damage spells.
Yep.
In fact, I think he is all damage spells.
I am our utility boy for the most part.
Yeah. I mean, he is all offense, baby.
Yep. He did say he likes playing glass cannons. I have nothing to help us with this endeavor either. Ooh. Can I do something wild?
You can try.
Can I ask my patron for guidance on this situation? My rambunctious fucking djinn.
Make a wish, you said.
I can't make wish. I wish I could make wish.
Let's see. Okay, sure. Come to think of it, we've never really talked about your patron, so this will be interesting.
He's kind of an asshole.
Which element is he?
A fire.
Oh, yeah, he's definitely an asshole then.
Yeah.
Okay, how do you wish to try and contact your patron?
I need something. Something interesante. Hey, Tootie, my friend. Do you have some weird-ass gems that aren't magical?
Give me just a minute to figure that out.
Weird gems, you say? Not magical. Nope.
Did we pick up some gems? Oh, did you already? Fuck.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot about my pixie bracelet I have on me. Cool.
Unless like my
nothing that I'm aware of.
Wrong.
It means I have a friendship with my with a pixie.
Unless you're what?
Unless my things seem cat, you better not fucking turn off my
turn it off. Do it.
You could use my orb of direction.
No.
Oh, it's that type of asshole.
Yeah, it's gotta be something vain.
How vain are we talking about?
I'd rather not.
Not that far. We just need something semi-vain, I should say.
Oh gosh, not the one thing that matters. Not the diamonds.
Have three.
Can we all get colored gems?
Maybe I can just play to his vanity. Maybe I can just offer him a song in his honor. Played out that way.
Okay. I am back. So.
Oh, he scared me a little bit. Yeah, I guess I'm just going to try to call out to his vanity and like just tell him how great, powerful, all-knowing in a little show and try to call upon his guidance.
Okay. Go ahead and make a performance check.
Okay. Performance check.
Mm-hmm.
On the bright side, most of these are really good.
21.
And you know what? For extra, just extra insurance, I don't even want to know if it's going to work yet or not, because I'm just going to do it.
Okay.
With an extra three, so 24.
24. You begin to strike up a song. What do you say about your patron?
I will just go into. Let me see. Hold on. I have his stuff written down here. Let me go and figure out what he's the most. Oh, wow, why did you just scroll all the way to the bottom all of a sudden? Don't do that to me. Yeah. I'm gonna call it he's Crocel? Crocel? I pronounce his name, I forget. The last person that he was bound to was actually Sinbad. Hmm. And so I'm going to use that to my advantage, just claiming how all of Sinbad's acts were actually secretly Crocel, pushing things in his favor, how, you know, just how mighty and powerful and all-knowing he basically is. We are beneath him and we are, you know, groveling for his help. Or I am. I don't know. I don't speak for the party. I speak for me.
Okay. As you begin to play your song, the rest of you nearby feel a drastic change in temperature. It begins to become very hot, almost like you're standing next to an open flame. And at a point nearby, Haleon, you begin to see smoke almost appearing out of nowhere. Black, ashy smoke begins to grow in heat and intensity till you begin to see flames flickering behind the smoke before they wrap in on themselves and emerging from the cloud of smoke and fire. A large, red-skinned torso. A face that is angry, barbaric even. Horns growing from various points on his head and big brass ring hoops through his ears. As he emerges from the fire and smoke and looks down at all of you and locks eyes with Haleon.
I'm gonna immediately just plant my face into the goddamn dirt. Oh, great one. Thank you. Oh, Cassium, here, thank you for heeding my call. I wish for guidance on what type of magic, that, you know, what is going on here, what kind of magic this is. If you can give us any kind of insight, see that what we cannot.
Let's see. He looks annoyed and says, everybody gets one small one. Consider this your one. Next time, don't call me, I'll call you.
Of course, no great one.
As for this, he crosses his arms and looks around the area before bringing his hands up to his face, and he blows what appears to be chunks of red-hot coal and ash into his hand. And without any regard to the rest of you, throws it out over the entire area. None of you get hurt, but you will walk away with a few singe places in your clothing and skin.
Nice.
As the smoke, ash, and rain kind of tumble down over it, he crosses his arms again and says, this is a shrine dedicated to very old and powerful magic. Specifically, it is meant to transport something of a very large scale to another plane. Which one? I can't say for sure, but he looks around at all the forests and flowers around and looks very pointedly at the elves in the group. I think I can hazard a guess.
I'm guessing the Fae world.
Indeed.
Hmm. Could you tell us if that's where they were actually sent? If anything went wrong?
It is active.
All right. Thank you, oh great one.
You owe me one for this, Haleon. And you know I'll collect.
As you command, I shall so be.
And with that, he kind of... And his form begins to shrink back down into that cloud of smoke and fire before dissipating away, leaving just a trace amount of ash that falls to the ground.
I'm going to gather that ash.
And he's kind of an asshole.
You all realize suddenly that you've been sweating due to your closeness to him and just the heat that radiates off his body.
Imagine having that guy in your head. He's not so bad once you get to know him. He just believes in quid pro quo.
Yeah. He just didn't seem too happy to be around the woods and the elves.
He's a spirit of fire. The literal opposite of all this nature. I wouldn't be too happy either. The only worst place I could probably go somewhere was the middle of an ocean.
There you go.
Well, I guess we can make our way back then to the captain. Or now, Chief Elder, as he is now, until...
He's the head honcho now.
Can we figure out what's going on?
Yep.
Well, gathering your group, you leave the Shrine of Exedition behind for now. And you make the 2-day journey back to Lefar. Is there anything anyone wishes to discuss on the road, or should I fast forward to returning to Lefar?
I think the only thing that Haleon wishes to discuss is about we need to either find somebody they can make contact. You know, we need to find a contact in the Fae Realm, or we need to gain passage to the Fae Realm, more than likely, to figure out what's going on or to see if everybody's okay in the city. See what happened to the city, probably.
I mean, I think our best bet for that.
With Maya. That little pixie friend that I made, she left me a bracelet. Does that do anything, or is it just a cute little bracelet?
It's a cute little bracelet.
Cool.
My best friends forever.
Although, if you know the right spells, it could potentially be used to track them down again.
We need to find a spell scroll of locate. Like locate person or whatever it is, I can't remember exactly.
Well, that's great. I don't know spells. I just have a pretty bracelet.
Trio will speak up as well and say that she agrees with Callum. Rylath would be a good place to start. That is where most of the druids congregate, and I'm sure they have a way of bringing you all to the Feywild.
Yeah. We can meet the Archdruid's daughter. Next in line.
I guess we'll do that.
Sounds good.
on the road again.
Okay. The 2 days go by in relative peace. And when you arrive at the far, things are much as you left them, for better or worse. The Rangers are still trying to hold out, and General Bariath is there overseeing the defense. When you arrive, Tria lets you know that she will go and speak with the commander and give her a report, and then she is sure that he will want to speak with you afterwards.
We'll just be, I guess we'll be in this house over here.
Okay.
I mean, we might as well be civil about this. We are civilized men. We can have a meeting inside a civilized building.
I mean, most of you are.
Look, I choose not to judge the thief and the vampire. They know not what they do.
Cook us up some basic foods. Sit around and have a meeting over some hot meal. Some stew, rabbit stew with potatoes.
As he goes right into the corner.
And some raw rabbit for our friend over here, Keely.
Yeah, bloody rabbit.
Yeah.
Bariath will enter shortly after, his head kind of down in thought. Captain Tria has updated me on the situation. The Archdruidess is dead, and the Shrine of Exedition has been activated. The city of Silwyn is locked away in the Feywild and unable to send aid. This is almost worst case. Normally, if I had all the resources I normally do at my disposal, I would ride out immediately to Rylath to try and determine what steps need to be taken to reverse the spell. But I only have these rangers at my command, and at the moment, I think we are better suited containing the Warforged threat here in Lafar for now. As much as we can, at least.
I agree. I mean, we've made dangerous travel so far. We'd be honored to go over to Rylath to go see what we can do instead. I have a general idea about this spell breaking, because I think we've met one of the, or found the tomb of one of these kings already. But we'll have to see.
In that regard, I can elucidate a little. The kings that the shrine references are titles that we have and have been passed down through the generations. It is somewhat like the Archdruidess. When it is our time to retire or to pass, we elect a successor. Now, ever since we came together and formed Silwyn, that system of the Kings of the Forest has been largely forgotten, but not discontinued. I am the current acting Eraine Oddfaroth. The Archdruidess was one as well. Now I suspect that that falls to her daughter. And you mentioned a tomb of one?
Yes, the tomb of the Arkandai, or Arkandel. The those are the music and scribes. We found it back over in Greetha, by perchance.
Interesting. That is one that the titles, whenever they are unable to be passed down organically, they are passed magically. So you certainly may have found a tomb of one, but someone else holds that title now, or will hold that title. So that still leaves two, for sure, that we need to track down, and I do not know of where they may be at this time. Or who they may be.
And time is not our factor in this situation. Pray tell, the druids can help us out in these times' needs, then.
If anyone would have even a figment, a scrap of knowledge to go off of, it would be them. They would also know a way to get us into the Feywild should we need to contact Silwyn directly. Frankly, I would like to know what their status is in the Feywild, if they are safe, or if they too are under siege.
Well then, besides just gathering the information for the quest to rebuild them, we're also gathering the information for you and get it to you as quickly as we can. Not that I have this, boys.
Does that mean I have a chance to become the Bard of Legend? What I've always wanted.
Perhaps.
I don't even care which legend, just a legend.
And while we're here, I'm going to take some foods that I made, some drink. Wait, why am I moving both of us?
Somehow
stop dancing with me, Callum.
Have both of them selected, I think.
I'm only clicking on my character and I can't unselect his.
Hit escape and then select your character again.
You broke me. What'd you do to me?
I'm just gonna reload. I hit escape and it just gave me the option to reload, so that's what I'm gonna do. Okay.
Baryath will reach into a pouch and from here on out, I think it would be best if people see you as acting on the behalf of the Rangers. And he steps over to the table, and he sets down a number of pens, enough for each of you.
Can we get Sweet's bag? Let's go.
These pens are maybe the size of a gold coin. And they feature the head of a stag. These are the pins that I give to my rangers to denote that they are under my direct command. These should inform the elders of the various villages and cities that you are working under my orders. Hopefully this will open doors that may previously have been locked to you.
Life's a little bit easier.
Thank you. I'll take a pin and go put it on my lapel. Or whatever the heck. Yeah, lapel works. That's a word I can say.
I wouldn't thank me. It also denotes you as working against these creatures. But something tells me that they know that already.
Yeah. I have one of those badges too. That's okay.
We're used to getting into trouble.
Now, you're welcome to stay here as long as you need to rest and recuperate. I don't have much to offer you in terms of supplies, but if you have questions, then I will answer what I can.
I'm good. I have the idea what we're trying to do.
Scanning the room and seeing as there are no questions, he will nod and say, I will be here should you have need of me. If anything happens to me between now and when we're able to reconvene at the shrine, know that I will be electing Captain Tria as my successor. And farewell. Safe journeys. Farewell. And perhaps soon we can discuss tales of this over cups of ale and wine.
I'd have it no other way.
That he'll take his leave.
Great, now we have two bosses.
Yep. So I was just thinking, like, wow, we're really getting mercenaried out right now, aren't we?
I mean, to be fair, between the two groups, this one's been a lot nicer. We didn't have any blood contracts made about us, so that's better.
True.
Well, I need to report, speaking of bosses, I do need to report back to our
other boss. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I haven't had time to open the gateway yet.
Might be something you can do along the road.
Exactly.
Away from prying eyes, hopefully.
Especially out of this village, away from things that don't want that thing.
All right. Well then, is there any special preparations you would like to make before you set out? And go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
And once you have everything, where are you headed?
I mean, our best bet is to go to Ryleth would be the best way to go to, right?
Yes.
It's where the Archdruid or the new one is anyway.
Yep, and that would give us the druids a way to get into the Feylands or to contact them. I think that's probably our best bet, or hope that it's still standing. Probably by taking the roads, it would take us around 4 days.
Yep.
And we know the road to Silwyn, so that's easy enough travels.
You could probably cut it to maybe 3 if you cut through the forest. Provided the ranger's favored terrain is still in effect.
Ranger? Is that his favorite terrain?
No idea. The ranger is not paying attention.
Let's see.
I never set up favorite terrain on that character. I did the alternative option.
You are right. You have favorite foe, key point, fangbite, dedicated weapon.
I never set up favorite terrain.
Okay, well then.
Yeah, I figured I was from an icy area anyways.
Then it would take you longer to go off-road.
Yeah, we'll take it to the roads. They're safer anyway for us at this time.
So the typical roads then?
I think so.
Okay. So along the road to Ryleth.
It would be way too risky.
And he stops along the way or going straight to Ryleth?
Oh, I mean, we'll make normal stops to rest, but I think unless we need supplies at one of the cities, I think we could good to just go through. Once whatever the party wants.
Okay.
Should be our number one priority.
Yeah, I'm good to just go. I can't think of any supplies I would need.
All right. And as you all begin your trek back along the road to Silwyn to pass by Silwyn, or what is left of Silwyn, and make your way on down to Ryleth. That is all I have planned for this session. Dun, dun, dun. And I've got to be at work a little early tomorrow, and I'm by myself all day, so.
Ooh, fun.
Not fun. Not fun at all. Yeah. So, this
well,
will
buddy,
be
it like, was fun.
Good a place as any to call it for now.
Yay. Yeah.